So gameplay with commentary, that's the most exciting thing today. Before we started, two things. The loading screen is not the loading screen from the game, you know, it's just for the Twitch purposes. And second, we can, okay, announcements.
Product placement.
Last time I did some stream, I exactly that there was a CNN news all the time running, so it was funny. So can we see? Tell us a bit about where are we now and what type of mission is this?
Okay, so first, Razo is lead gameplay programmer. He is responsible for all the gameplays and all the missions which we have in the game, and we are working together since almost beginning of the Madfinger games. This level is side quest. There will be a lot of side quests, I think almost 100. It's on the first planet, which was lost in the battle with the aliens before a year or so. So there is no real army. There is only light infantry army who is trying to reconstruct this planet for the aliens business. So this is the human dump. And it was reconstructed by the aliens to support the core, and they are using them for some barricades or whatever.
So they are using our technology for
Kind
them.
of, they are assimilating our technology to use for their own cause.
Bastards, can you do something about it?
Yeah, we'll shut down the core.
Sir, there are people saying that this is pre-recorded. Can you do something special?
It's not pre-recorded. Okay, so
Nothing's happening.
shoot to the ground. Okay?
Don't die.
Yeah, and don't die. Yeah, that's right. But it's definitely, I can see it here. If you don't believe me. Okay, so we'll call these guys. So
Kill them and show it on the camera that it's running on the iPhone.
I don't think they will see it, but
No, we have to move there.
Okay, let me finish this fight and we can do something crazy so you can believe us. You kind of broke my choreography here, but it's okay.
No, you do a great job.
All right, so what should I do to prove it's like live gameplay?
Show
it on the camera.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Turn it and show it.
And
Sorry?
Zoom in.
Where is the camera? This one? Can you zoom in?
I'll be
Camera is there, not on the monitor.
Yeah, the control guy.
Yep. We're
Is it
live.
okay?
Yeah, that's perfect.
Yeah, that's enough.
And it's running smooth 60 FPS.
60 FPS. That's
And it's iPhone 7.
So there you go.
And not special one.
All right, so it was pre-recorded video for the Sorry for that.
And this is one of the serious mission. We have a lot of a little bit
Like crazy?
crazy missions,
Okay.
and yeah, it's on the beginning of the game, so it's not so difficult, and also it's balanced for the CES demo or CES, and so we decrease the difficulty so the journalists don't die.
Yeah, I will tell you something about it. That's for the journalists, because journalists are usually not that great gamers. So if you feel that it's really easy, it definitely won't be easy in the final game. It's like that. And just one thing to mention, it's still pre-alpha, so there are ton things to do, and it's
It's several months old, so we have a lot of new things, and we improve a lot of things like the animations or moving of the characters. And yeah,
But the level of detail is unbelievable for
yep, no degrade.
Okay. Can you just tell your words like real-time reflections and stuff
Oh
like
yeah,
that? I don't
you
understand
can see
really.
them actually here, you know, and the tech is using like normal maps basically on everything, which is not usual on mobile nowadays, so it's kind of very forward with the technology
It's definitely not,
we are
yeah.
doing. You can see, you know, like the daylight is reflected on the floor.
Everything is dynamic, and you have problems to see any pixels, so textures are very high resolution, and there is detail maps and everything, so yeah, it looks really good.
It's the next gen for mobile gaming.
I
Like
think
that.
so, yeah.
New generations of games are coming.
detail maps. There's even bloom on the camera, so kind of triple A effect.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you see that we have some variety of the enemies, and this is one of the tougher guys, and you cannot penetrate him through the shield, so you have to aim just to body,
uh-huh.
And you know, he will play some animation that you have to kill him really fast, or you can use skills like the and use the same thing.
That was a special skill. So what is it about, and how many skills do we have in the game?
Because we don't want to have only shooter. We want to have some kind of the variety. It's more RPG FPS game,
mm-hmm.
And we will have around 50 skills, which are split between the passive and active skills. You can choose two active skills to use,
mm-hmm.
them. You can change them in the real time, what is suitable for the current gameplay or for your playstyle.
Okay.
And yeah, but we will talk about it probably in the next week.
Okay, can give us few examples. I know that you hate these questions, like tell us the whole skill tree right now.
For example, this is what's the name?
Shockwave.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Because we are still changing names, so I don't remember. It was Stomp, now it's Shockwave. And we have invisibility, we have blink, we have,
mm-hmm.
Like typical skills, for example, throwing grenades or turrets,
yeah.
But we will have a lot of crazy skills there.
Okay, you switch weapons, so how many weapons will you have?
I'm kind of trying to surprise them here. You can see the shielder behind the grate.
Uh-huh.
So you will have three weapons in the mission. It's primary,
mm-hmm.
It's secondary, which is sniper or machine gun or rocket launcher or,
mm-hmm.
whatever, like the heavy guns. And you will have in holster a pistol. So this is your last weapon if you are running out of the ammo. So
that's the bad sign. If you shoot with pistol, that's the bad sign that mission goes wrong. What is it? Is it a secret?
Yes, we are planning, and we have a lot of hidden places.
I love
for
it.
For the exploration and with some nice loot or some other stuff. So the people who wants to explore, who wants to find things and have time, they can explore it and find all the hidden places.
Okay.
We also create new thing for the, as you notice, he's using iron sight, but there is no button. And because we hate buttons, as I said, you know, we want to have auto fire on everything, but the iron sight is not auto. You're basically,
mm-hmm.
using double tap to use.
Can you show it if you do that double tap?
Yep.
Okay.
It's very intuitive,
uh-huh.
very easy, and you don't need to press specific space.
Yeah, the controls are very smooth because you can even switch between sprinting and regular running just by pushing the kind of a hidden joystick more forward.
Okay.
I will show you. So this is just me regulating the speed with the left thumb.
Uh-huh.
So we have basically only like three buttons right now on the screen, two for the skills and one for the switching weapons. Otherwise everything is automated.
No, automated. It's
well, kind of, you know, like you don't have to trigger it by pressing some buttons. It's playing very smooth, you know, for a mobile shooter.
I think our best control scheme which we had,
from
all the games.
And
we need it because we have to have their real gameplay as is on the consoles, a lot of enemies and a lot of actions, and we have to work on the control scheme to be as fluent as possible and very easy to use, but still hard to master, so there will be difference for the really good hardcore people and compared to casual guys.
Yeah, I think we reinvented ourselves with this control scheme.
That's cool.
To be honest.
Okay.
So
explosive barrel.
So we destroyed the two supporting generators. Now we have to,
mm-hmm.
finish the main core, which is used for powering the warp gates.
We had a question. Was that John Slade who is giving you orders?
What's the
No, this is your sidekick who is in the dropship. JuneSplit is giving you all the epic missions, some side quests or side missions, and he is in the hub. So we'll directly talk with him.
So the destroy the core is your main mission.
Yeah, yeah, after that you will basically blow the whole thing.
Okay.
So as you see, the there is a lot of enemies on the screen. It's still running really well. The fight is intense. You know, he's not getting any damage because, like I said, it's a little bit decreasing difficulty. Mm-hmm. So
it's because I'm hardcore player.
He's really good. And yeah.
There is one guy who died during that journalist demo, but I can't name him.
Yeah, him.
But I played on gamepad.
Why we decided to invite Razo.
I'm having fun, guys.
So yeah, you have to clean the room, then
okay.
Do as much damage as possible.
Oh,
did I died.
Oh.
I think I blew up the explosive barrels and I was standing next to them.
So there are two guys who died during the journalist demo.
You kind of like call it upon myself, because this is my like 20th run today and I never died. So.
Okay, so you see the Brazil screen, which you don't want to see too often.
Should I do a speed run?
Yeah, do a speed run.
Okay. Because there's like cool ending, you know, that you don't want.
Yeah, we would love to. We would love to see a definitely cool ending, but can you do a speed run?
Sure.
Okay.
Now I will bring my A game.
So second attempt on the journalist demo from an experienced guy.
You know, guys, these things happen. It's life.
No. I must say that it's so difficult to talk and play. And I try some stream stuff, and it was like when I get in the game, I can't talk, and when I talk, I can't get in the game. So
yeah, it's difficult.
So
it's not
so
easy.
Surprise, no shame, no shame.
There's a question, no checkpoints.
Yes, there will be. We don't have it implemented in this demo because we didn't expect that somebody will die. So, but yes, it will move you to the same or before the room where you died, basically. So don't worry, you don't have to play.
I'm so glad that I'm not the only one.
So as you see, the shooter is using covers. You have a lot of covers around the mission. They are able to hit there and shoot you. It's we never plan to have some crazy shooters because it's frustrating for the player when they are too much good. So we try to split it that the melee guys are most dangerous if they are on the close range.
Yeah.
So they can kill you really fast in the back. And shooter is not, you know, they are like the pain in the, I can't say it, but you have to kill them. There will be a variety of the guys. We will talk about it in the next week.
Uh-huh.
So we will change them. We have some enemies which you don't see there here because it's the first mission, so we don't want to reveal all
of
the
course,
enemies inside the first missions. And yeah.
There are actually some hidden secrets in this level, but I won't spoil them for you. You will play it later.
You just showed that, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the way to get to that second chest is pretty tricky. So.
Okay.
Yeah. Nobody found it.
I didn't see that, definitely.
Also, don't forget that I think you don't have these kind of the skills. So we definitely don't have shockwave.
At the beginning of the game.
Yeah.
Uh huh. Okay.
So this is why he can be really fast, and also they are recharging faster than they should.
Yeah.
The final game.
Yeah, journalist gaming, kind of.
But as you see, he can aim really, really good, like the really fast, and even on the touch screen, it looks like that he's playing on the gamepad. At least I think.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, the controls are really like responsive, you know, like you want to do something, you will break the previous action, you know, like you are reloading, you want to switch weapon, it can happen, you know, in no time, you don't have to wait for animation to finish. So everything's pretty responsive.
Yeah, the animations look gorgeous.
And we have like kind of AAA ragdolls physics that's not even in some PS4 games.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we are using also new animation system. We didn't use it in previous games. So in Unity is mechanic, right?
Yeah.
And we are using it heavily, so we can plant animation. Yeah, we have different reloads. So when you are inside the fight, you are using different reloads. It's faster, and even it's you are shooting in different, so the weapon is more crazy because you want to mimic the stress when you are inside the combat.
Mm-hmm. There is no stress, just, you know, finishing.
I don't want to mess it up at the same place, you know. Stay away from the barrels.
So what does the shockwave do? It stuns enemies?
Yeah, it knocks them down.
Oh.
It's probably not balanced well. We want to keep them on the ground for longer periods,
mm-hmm.
so we have more time to finish them and do some kind of the fatalities or whatever. No, people don't have fatalities probably, but like the finish
down,
them.
Down, left, 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 down,
yeah, yeah, something like
that. I hate that.
There we go.
All right, so.
Yeah. Finally, it's done.
Well, that was...
Don't die.
Get to the dropship. So you have limited time?
Yeah, because
okay.
Everything is
now you need
exploding.
Right?
Just to be safe.
And yeah, you have to return to the dropship. You change a little bit. There is fire, a lot of particles,
uh-huh.
some enemies to trying to get some revenge. And yeah, you still have plenty of time because, as I said, it's for the demo. We will probably decrease it.
Okay. So 45.
Well, I think it could be pretty tight.
Yeah. That looks amazing.
That's how I'm coming.
30 seconds ahead.
Oh, it's okay.
Yeah. Hey! What is that poster there?
You know, some Shirogun stuff. They like to tint their interiors, you know, with their, even beer kegs, you know, on the floor because they are living
okay.
this kind of like rockstar life.
You know, that mood that those Shirogun are specials and they are crazy, it should be everywhere.
Mm.
So we want to promote it inside the game. We want to that people will, or players will feel special and really badass. It's not just a... It's one of our main focus that you will really get this feeling from it.
Mm-hmm.
And for good.
All right.
All right, so that's it.
Razo, thank you very much.
No worries.